In this video, we highlight inspection techniques used to detect West Indian drywood termite. While subterranean termites need contact with the ground to maintain moisture in their nests and tunnels to survive, drywood termites get their moisture requirement straight from the wood itself, making them hard to detect. One way to detect WIDT is through their droppings, called frass, which is often found on windowsills, on bedclothes, and on the floor. Other identifiable features of WIDT is the shape of the soldier head, as shown on screen, and their clean workings. Their tunnels and galleries are also cleaned with dry pellets of frass, unlike the muddy or caked appearance of subterranean termite galleries. When carrying out your inspection, you'll need a strong torch to detect the frass and a donger to detect potential termite activity. Frass can be light or dark in colour and is often the first visible sign of drywood termite activity. Another distinguishable feature of WIDT are the wings of the alate, which have a bluish pink tinge to them. Because drywood termites can start a colony anywhere within a building, as they don't require ground contact and can enter through an open door or window, inspections need to be thorough and should always include the roof and void space. One of the most effective ways to detect WIDT is through thermal imaging, with infrared cameras able to detect the heat signatures of drywood termites huddled together as they feed. Another tool used to detect WIDT is a moisture meter, which can identify areas where termite activity is more likely to occur. Always calibrate this device in a dry area prior to use, and always pick up and place the meter on a surface instead of dragging it. If you find or believe West Indian drywood termites are present, it must be reported as soon as possible to the Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. For more information on WIDT, visit daf.qld.gov.au and remember to follow these simple steps to stop WIDT from spreading.